I grew up in the Great Lakes area of Ontario, Canada, and there are thousands of shipwrecks. And I wasn't a scuba diver at the time, so I was looking for something that would really allow me to get into the story and see the shipwrecks from below. It all started one night when I dropped a flashlight off my boat in Lake Huron, and I said, you know what we really need is a robot to go get that. Started out as a bit of a joke, but then I really got interested in the concept and the idea of having it. My name is Sam McDonald, and I'm the president of Deep Trekker. We learned that a lot of the suppliers of the components to build ROVs and underwater drones were really priced out of the market. So we undertook to design every piece of the Deep Trekker DTG2 ourselves. This allowed us to make a low-cost but still high-quality product. Both of the ROVs are made of cast aluminum bodies, so they're really rugged, built to last. We were international out of the gate with our first purchase order coming from a fish farm supplier in Norway. So we have such a spectrum of different people using it for different things, things I never even imagined when we first started the company. We have scientists out there collecting data with our ROVs. We sell ROVs to military, we sell to commercial and salvage divers, underwater archaeology, environmental agencies and research, and of course we still sell to people who are just interested and curious about what's below the waves. Our manufacturing and testing process has come a long way since the beginning. We have a very rigorous quality control and testing process. We have specially made pressure tanks right in-house so that we can test every single unit that leaves our shop at up to 1,000 feet of pressure in a simulated environment. We've even designed new product lines for our customers. Our brand new DT340 pipe crawler was developed because a customer was trying to use the ROV product and it just wasn't what he needed. We designed it for potable water, municipal water systems, sewage systems, but because we were already making waterproof products with the ROV, we thought, well, let's take that technology and apply it to a pipe crawler. I can't tell you where we're gonna take this company in 5 years or 10 years' time, but I can tell you that we're gonna continue to make great, accessible robots, listening to our customers, and growing what we're doing every day.